Hi there, and welcome to the Maya Learning Channel. In the previous movie, I placed all my vehicles into a collection using an expression, both to isolate them in the viewport as well as to separate them in rendering for composition. However, that had the unfortunate side effect of removing reflections and refractions. In this video, I'll show you how to get those back. I'm going to start by displaying the layer we created in the previous video, which right now consists of just my vehicles. However, in order to reflect things like the buildings and people, also known as casters, I'll need to include them in the same layer as the cars. However, I'll separate them out into their own collections, starting with casters set. This collection will be for all my set elements, such as buildings, trees, mailboxes, and so on. But for now, I'll start with just one building for testing purposes. Now the render shows my cars in this one building, which is properly reflected in their windows. Of course, the problem is that this is no longer a car-only layer. To solve this, I'm going to use the collection to do something called an attribute override. This is one of RenderSetup's most powerful tricks. First, overrides need to be applied specifically to layers and collections, so I need to make sure one of them is active and selected before I begin. Then I'll select the building I want to override and navigate to its Shape tab. Down in the Arnold section, you'll notice this matte attribute. This controls whether an object is lit properly or blacked out in renders. This is perfect since I want to hide the building in my vehicle layer. However, rather than simply turn it on, I'll right-click and select Create Absolute Override for Visible Layer. Again, this menu will only appear if I have an active layer, otherwise it won't be here. Notice the orange, which indicates the attribute is now being overridden by the layer. And sure enough, if you look in the render setup window, you'll see an override entry here, which I'll turn on. Now if I render again, the building vanishes while its reflection remains. Awesome. Also, notice how RenderSetup created a subcollection that includes all shape nodes from its parent before applying the override. Maya created this collection automatically when I overrode the mat using the right-click menu. In other words, I didn't override this one building's specific mat so much as I overwrote the attribute name mat and then applied it to every object in the layer. The reason this distinction is so important is because it allows me to change the composition of my parent collection by, say, including my entire set namespace via expression. Don't forget to use double colon to get all the nested namespaces too. Now everything in set appears in the layer. However, a red border appears around the visibility button, indicating that its overrides are no longer up to date, i.e. they're dirty. To fix that, I'll just click it. This applies the same matte override to all the new objects, which I can double check by re-rendering. Notice how many more reflections there are? However, some of my set is still missing. For example, this whole other side of the street. There are also a lot fewer trees and grass patches than there should be. This is because they're not part of the set namespace, so they weren't picked up by the expression. This is a common occurrence when combining assets from various sources. In this case, someone else worked on these resources and wasn't aware of our namespace organization. To more easily find what we're missing, I can turn on the render setup filter in the outliner. This gives me the option of seeing what's in or out of a selected layer. In this case, I'll choose out. It'll take Maya a moment to recalculate the outliner, since it needs to run a search. Once it finishes, you'll see these color-coded lines indicating what's in a collection. Then I can just add anything appropriate that was missed. So this bus stop, these buildings, and from the looks of it, everything in these groups, which I'll handle via some additional expressions. You'll notice a bit of lag every time I update the collection due to the outliner filter constantly being recalculated. That lag will go away once I turn the filter off. But before that, I still need to add this hydrant and these trees. There, that looks good. Then I'll update the overrides. And we should be good to go. Well, something went wrong because the buildings are still there. What gives? It turns out that this isn't because we did anything wrong per se, but rather because these aren't true Maya objects. They're actually cached Arnold objects that were created in Maya or some other DCC, then imported and represented in the viewport as stand-in nodes. That's what these STD acronyms stand for. Think of them as lightweight proxies. To show you what I mean, let me just select one and look in the attribute editor. See the asset file being referenced here? I can still mat this out, but I need to do so via this stand-in override section. Activating override mat will allow these stand-ins to follow the same matting as the regular Maya objects. And there we go, all fixed. Finally, I'll turn off the filters again to avoid calculating constant updates. So far, so good. Now, using those same skills, I can create additional caster collections for my background characters and hero character, then mat them out too. Now our vehicle only layer has all the necessary reflections and refractions without actually rendering anything except the vehicles themselves. However, I still need to get rid of the background HDR image, which as you'll recall is included by default because we're including all lights in all layers. I still want to include that light since I need it for reflections and refractions, so instead, what I can do is select the light and reduce its camera attribute to 0. This will remove the HDR image without affecting its lighting. Perfect. But just in case I do want the background from time to time, I'll include it in another override. I'll call this collection MPT for matte painting. Then add the HDR Skydome and override the camera attribute we just changed. Notice that this time Maya gives me the choice between a relative override or absolute override. A relative override adds the layer's override value to the attribute's current value. In this case though, I'd prefer to use an absolute override to control the entire thing. That'll make it easy to turn on and off on command. See? So, just to review, this layer's main focus is around my vehicles. All these other casters are there in support of those vehicles. To make that clear, let's name it Props Vehicles. Now to get that same functionality for other elements like background characters, hero characters, and set, I need to create similar layers for them as well. Thankfully, I won't have to do so from scratch. Instead, I can just copy and paste my existing layer. Pasted elements appear in bold italics, the importance of which I'll get into in a later video. For now though, I'll rename this BG Characters and make it active. ~90% of the setup is already done for this layer, but instead of matting out the people, I want to mat out the vehicles. So that means Caster's CHR will become just CHR. And vehicles will become Caster's vehicles. Then I'll just middle drag the override subcollection from one to the other. Then I'll refresh the overrides. Render again. And there it is, easy as that. Then I'll copy and paste twice more for the heroes and set. We're almost done, there's just one last thing to take care of. Notice that for each layer, matted objects will block things that they appear in front of, like how this car blocks these background characters, which is useful for framing. More subtly, I've also used it to cut off the bottom of these car tires, in order to give them the flatter look they need when on pavement. However, one place I don't want this cutting to happen is on the set itself. To understand why, consider that our set is essentially the backdrop that we'll be layering other stuff on top of. If we cut holes in it, we risk exposing a bit of those holes in the renders. Leaving the background intact eliminates that risk. So for this layer specifically, we don't want to mat things out, but instead remove them entirely while still retaining their reflections and shadows. The attribute named primary visibility will allow us to do that. So I'll start with the vehicles by first deleting the existing mat override. Then I'll select my collection and then any part of my car. Go to the Arnold section and overwrite the primary visibility instead. Just like before, Maya applies this primary visibility override not just to the part of the car I selected, but to all the identically named attributes within the selected collection. Then I'll turn it off. And as you can see, the cars have vanished from my render, while leaving their shadows behind. Then I can copy and paste that change to the other caster collections too. Now I have a nice solid background to lay my other elements on top of. This ability to override different attributes is what makes render setup so powerful, but it can be used for much more than just hiding things. In the next video, I'll get more into the nitty-gritty of overriding attributes to optimize scene performance, both for single-frame renders and batch renders.